Namely means what?
Like, we want to create classroom, but we cannot create.
And that should be a defect, right? That should, that is not a risk. That is a defect. That is what you are testing to confirm that, okay, suppose this what happened. My expected result is like this. But I cannot create the classroom. That is a failed test case, and that is defect. So that is not your risk. You get changes of the functionality, yes, it is a risk for you. But if the functionality is not working accordingly, that is not a risk. That is what you want to try to prove here. That you want to do functionality tests for you to identify where is the defect. So that is not your risk for you to propose a solution for it. You get? So the second risk is not acceptable one. Functionality changes, yes. While you are doing test planning here, right? They do changes. Then now you need to do changes according to what they have changed. You get? So if a functionality is not working correctly, it means that is the proof that the functionality is not work. So that will be your result for the test case. Got it? Okay.
If changes in requirement.
Changes in the, don't say changes in requirement. Of course, the changes in the functionality happen due to the changes of requirement. But we are not dealing anything with the requirement. So what we can see, the functionality changes. So don't put anything about requirement. Just put changes of functionality. Correct? So your risk is changes of functionality, yeah?
Are we done? Operating in over 400 cities, including Singapore, Hong Kong, Thailand, and Malaysia. So FoodPanda growth is propelled by tech innovation and operational prowess. And then FoodPanda is a leading delivery platform in Asia and selected parts of Europe that is dedicated to bringing consumers a wide range of foods, groceries, and more quickly and conveniently. So,
what is that 1, 2?
Oh, it's the reference.
You need to do citation, not just listing the number. You need to use the APA format. Don't forget later.
So, it is powered by the cutting edge technology and operational efficiency. So, FoodPanda's continues to refine accessibility and convenience for its users. So that's for the introduction.
We don't need this because this is what you are going to do the test case later. like to do the number verification, email verification, all this is, I mean the data, all this is actually your data data. Like all the lists there, right, that will be your test data. The name, email address, contact number. So we don't need to talk about that under the test item yet. You can copy and keep it for you to use later, but you don't need to put under here. So here we just need user module, function 1 to function 2, enough. So that explanation down there, no need. Because I saw you put some briefing about each of the functions. Scroll back. I saw. Because you don't need to talk about the user friendly, the security, no need all that. Scroll to the second function. No, we don't need. Just follow that first thing. That's not. Because your explanation, right, is more to non-functional side. We don't need that. So the one in the between just now, right? That is what you need for your test data, what are the data, and that will be your test case later. It means like what are the best you want to do. So we don't need here. Just list the module, the functionality 1 and 2 something. Unless you talk about login function, registration function. Not about like the, like, you know, all these things like security, all these things.
Just
a simple sentence. Yes, because test item means we just want to make sure that these are the items we will test later. Because this function is what you will use for your test design technique, and then you prepare the test. So we just list down the functionality. That's it. So nothing much to explain that.
And then I will
can we take out those? That is what? That is module name, isn't it? The user registration, authentication, browsing, and searching. That is module. I still want this as a paragraph, not like numbering. What you can do is you can directly talk about the inside part. Yeah, correct. So you just put all this into the paragraph. We don't need the heading part. So directly put as a paragraph. It's just like overall, this is the functionality you are having.
The second one is my functionality interesting. And the third is ensure a consistency and user-friendly interface.
No. We are not doing user-friendly interface. This is what I was saying. Consistency, user-friendly, response, all this is more to usability testing. If the UI has been designed nicely, you know, all those things. We are not checking that. What we are checking is when we are doing the functionality testing, is those UI elements working or not? For example, login. We have login button. Login button is not functional requirement. That is more to UI functional testing. So that's why together with this functionality, we have this UI functionality testing. That's why I said not UI testing, not usability testing. It's more to element, UI element. Like the third one, the button, the links, you know. If those are working or not, that's all what we are covering. So we don't cover about how good is the UI. Correct? We don't check on the consistency, the responsiveness, the accessibility. We don't. So we just want to see if those UI elements are working or not to support the functionality testing. Okay, so take out all those things.
And the first is
setting the system response to invalid and so on. And then error message will verify you from out the message. And then grateful integration, until the system gracefully the error without cresting.
What exactly is the third one doing? I think number one and two is suitable. Number three is not, because it is more to non-functional, right? It means the system able to perform, to handle the errors without crashing or this. That is more to non-functional requirement. So only put the one and two. The third one must be.
And then there is the testing of power. The first is performance and testing.
Like what I said, you just make them as a character, but no need the number. Because you are going very detailed, you know. Actually, this is just to show you are not covered. So you don't even know the other to go very detailed, one by one, all of them. Okay? So you can just put them as a character. So here it should be performance testing, security testing. So just put them as a character. No need to like break down what type of stress or you can just talk in a general. Anything to do with the stress, we are not covering. That's enough.
So next will be the stakeholders. So the internal stakeholders include the employees, the quality testers, and the management team.
Who is the management team here?
The executive and the chief members.
Because internal stakeholder will be your section. As a testing team here, you are the internal stakeholder. So employee of?
Employee of our team.
Are they part of the testing?
No.
So who will be the part of the testing? Normally will be the testers, and then you can have like a test manager or test leader to separate as a leader, that is one person, and then the testers. Enough. So it's just about you. No need about whoever other people part of the company, but not part of the testing. We don't need that. Only the testing related people from your side, that is internal. And the external will be people who is related to football. That's it. So here you will have three different end users. Customer, delivery riders, restaurant partners. These three, they are considered end user of football. Correct? Then, board of directors will be related to football. Correct? So those three will be end user, correct? Restaurant partners also part of the end user. So you can put end user, okay? You can put end user and then in the backend customer. End user in the backend delivery, end user in the backend restaurant partners. So this is stakeholders. Other than that, this will be like the management team of food vendors.
So we are talking about now just to mention the first one is the order accuracy, the most of the inaccuracy processing the order, like when they receive the order, I got obviously.
This is not part of this. This is part of that state. Order, if it's not accurate, it's not a risk for your testing. It's a risk for the order. It's not disturbing your testing. Do you get what I'm saying? Because this is more to like, if they didn't do the order accordingly, there is any incorrect data, what will happen? Will it stop your testing? No. So we don't need this. This is actually part of your testing result later. If there's any incorrect happen in the order, what is the test result? This is part of testing, not part of this. So, payment processing issue due to
system.
So, your risk actually, the down of the system. payment issues, all this is actually not part of this. Delivery details, is it going to risk your testing? No, this is not. Your risk is enough. Product risk means you have planned to conduct your testing and due to this app, because we said product here means the Food Panda app is giving you a problem. What kind of problem which can disturb your testing? It can be due to the down of the application, where you cannot access to the application. So this can be due to any technical issue, or it can be due to server down. So those kind of things will be risk. Other than that, if suddenly they remove any of the functionality which you want to test, can you continue with your testing? No. If suddenly they modify the functionality, just now you listed the test item, right? And when they modify those functionality, can you test? No. So that will be the type of product risk. Something comes straight from the product, the application. So not this kind of thing. This is like a problem in the test case. Due to this, due to that, no. Okay? Can I see the project list? So project list will be more to our side now. The testing team side problem. Not product anymore. Project means our side. So this can be due to the testing tool, okay? Unstable of testing environment. Insufficient or accurate test data, then I will blame you. Why you find data which is not sufficient for testing? Why you didn't find accurate data? It means you didn't do the test data gathering accordingly. So that is not a risk. Actually, test data is part of test environment. So if you said test data, you want to make it part of the risk, you can talk as the test environment, what was it? Inadequate of test environment, correct? The second one. Sorry, unstable testing environment. So this is this. This one is not. This one, your problem. You didn't find the correct data. So other than that, you can say about, what was it? Any problem about testers? Like resignation of testers, unavailability of testers, okay, or testers lack of understanding of using testing tool, those kind of things. Okay, so product is more to the Food Panda application, project is more to your side. That's it. Okay, Dada? Okay. Yeah.